Yo, what's up? It's your girl Miranda Wright, and you're listening to Pop Radio, iHeartRadio, Intellectual Radio, and we got a show for you lined up tonight. We have Spotlight of the Artists. We have Young Fly in the Building. Yeah. Yeah. We got 100 grand in the building. We got Boji in the building, and we also got Boss Blaze. Don't forget our special night that we always have, Models of the Week. We got something special for y'all, so stay tuned.
Let's get it, y'all. Prince of Pain back one more week here on Pop Radio, Caliente Radio, iHeart Radio, Intellectual Radio. Always been blessed and pop. I'm really not supposed to be here today, Earl. I just got out the hospital with pneumonia yesterday, but I'm here. Thank you for holding me down, and let me come in last minute because I really don't know if I was going to be here today or not. But shout out to Cat and Montana. She's been with me all day. I don't slow down. We shot two music videos today. We're not done. We're leaving straight here to go finish two more, or the same two videos. I got wonderful energy in the building. I got beautiful ladies. I got tough ones, the tall ones, short ones, brown ones, Mexican ones. But again, man, this is the only show in the Midwest on Thursday nights that features models, features dancers, features community activists and people doing good around the city of Chicago. Like I said, I got beautiful ladies. To my left today, I got Kimberly Hare. Say what's up, Kimberly.
Yo, what's up?
What's up? What's
How y'all doing tonight?
Feels good.
Over here at the very end, I got La Latina in the house. Kay in the building. Say hi, Kay.
Hi.
Right next to her, I have Doriel. Make some noise over there, beautiful. And look, I ain't got 6ix9ine, I ain't got Christina Aguilera, but I got my lovely host man who switched it up today looking super fly, Anita Mack in the building.
Hey, y'all already know what it is, Anita Mack in the building.
Yes, yes. Kodak Red is right. Well, you know what? It's raining today. I'm going to change it because I don't see no red today. You hear me? But Kodak Red is in the building. She's down. Yeah, she down. You know, she in the she on the squad today, working with us, and hopefully she'll be with us for a while.
You already
so,
know.
Last but not least, Chicago Bridge Magazine is definitely in the building. I said it before. How you doing, my brother?
I'm here, baby, man. I'm here, man. I'm blessed. Man, I'm really glad that you made it here, man. You know what I'm saying? That was traumatic. You know what I mean? Not many people, baby, get out of that hospital, man. Blessings to you, brother.
Sure. It's all God, man. He's got a job for me to do. I got things to wake up tomorrow. I got mama to take care. I can't lay down too much, man. I got too much to do. So all glory to God, number one, you know, so that's why I'm here. You're here for a reason. And real quick, before we get to that reason, I want to send a shout out real quick to the people who keep me in business and my sponsors, which is Chicago Lead Alliance, Worldwide Distribution and Publishing, and also the wonderful people over there on Ashland and Wabasca, Street Level Youth or Media. Make sure you got kids that need after school programs, kids that want to learn how to make videos and record music, free after school programs. Get up with Duke or Lisa, Street Level Youth Media. Don't forget it. So let's get back to Chicago, Chicago Bridge Magazine. Number one, I let you, you know, break the news. Well, I do got to get to a body first because I know you got a couple of events you have to get to tonight.
Yes, sir.
So what brought you to Pop Radio tonight, sir?
Man, I'm really glad to be here with all the lovely ladies on this panel today. You know, a bunch of
sweet ladies.
peace queen, you feel me? But man, actually what brings me out tonight is because we're gonna do a front cover presentation, man. I definitely wanna congratulate you for making the front cover of Chicago Bridge Magazine. But before I reveal you on the front cover, let me speak a little bit about the meaning of how important it is to represent a 19-year black-owned publication out of Chicago. You know, it all started with a dream from a lady named Bridget Wiley.
Remember.
Yeah, man, she's given a lot of people opportunities ever since going back to 1999. And she actually gave me an opportunity back in 2002. That's how long I've been grinding and rocking with this magazine. And with that being said, you know, I started off as a salesman. You know what I mean? I worked my way up to, you know, management status or whatever like that. You feel me? And just like a lot of hard work and grinding, man. And what we do is at the Chicago Bridge Magazine, we like to highlight, you know, artists. We like to highlight models. We like to highlight people in business, entrepreneurs, anyone that falls under that umbrella, you feel me? And you was definitely someone that caught our eye. And, you know, you've been grinding for a long time. You've overcome the impossible. And, you know, we definitely want to salute you. What a better compliment but to put a brother like you on the front cover of Scholar Bridge magazine. So with that being said, if I may, man, it's my ultimate pleasure, brother. Me being celebrity interviewer, I said it, the poet, to present you with the front cover of Chicago Bridge magazine. And we're going to do it just like this.
Oh, wow.
Okay,
yeah,
we'll
man.
Do this.
Fresh
okay.
out the bag.
Do this. Okay.
Wow, I wasn't expecting all this.
Man, congratulations, brother, man. Look how beautiful that is, ladies. Mm.
God bless you guys, man.
Man, it's my pleasure, brother.
Show it to the people watching us on YouTube and social media. Man, your boy popped and came out here not knowing what the, you know, this true story, man. That brother right there, Mr. Earl Winfrey, can bear witness to the first time I walked through the doors of Intellectual Radio. I just came home from prison. I just did 20 years. And at the time, Earl had about 70 shows, right? Earl, a few years ago. He's got over 80 shows now. He got TV shows now, you know? So I came through the door to get an interview by one of his hosts, then another one. Then another one. Then one more. And then Earl, you know, it wasn't long before Earl took a liking to me. And he really liked my artistry. You know, he liked my poetry. And we rocked out since then. He took me up under his wing. He made me an iHeartRadio host, gave me my own show, believed in me, still believes in me to this day, and still's in my inbox giving me mentorship. And making me be a better person, and it's brought me to things like this that, I mean, I don't even know how to take it. Like, I be in awe sometimes, you know, with some of my accomplishments and some of the things I do. Earl will tell you, I've won awards. I gave my award to Earl, and I'm sure he probably, my first award I think I won. You still got it in here, Earl? Ooh, my God. Could somebody grab that for me, please? I gave that to Earl a couple years ago. So that was my first award I ever won in Chicago. I think I won Best Storyteller 2013 for Chicago Spoken Word Lounge, if that's the award. Yeah, and you know, if you guys get this, it's got Eddie Prince on the back, whatnot. And Earl meant so much to me, man, that to me it's more the accomplishment, man, than the physical material. You know, people think that I'm rich or whatnot. I mean, I done accomplished some things. But what make you rich is what you got inside, man. It ain't material things. I was locked away and I felt free sometimes. And there's people out here that's free and feel locked up, you know. So all I got to say about this is I appreciate you guys. I'm very humbled. I'm honored. I got nothing but love for the Chicago Bridge Magazine and everything it represents. And thank you, man. I appreciate it. Bridget, Miss Bridget Whitey, I love you. You see it here on Pop Radio, Intellectual Radio, iHeartRadio. You hear it here. Make sure you go follow the community. Chicago Bridge Magazine, man, on all social media platforms.
Take it to the block. My shorties know I've been a ball.